Did you know that the next total lunar eclipse will give us a massive 1 hour and 22 minutes of totality? To photograph the blood moon like never before? That's more than 80 minutes of pure magic. And it is our last chance this year to photograph a total lunar eclipse. But when and where will it be visible? Why does the moon turn red? And how do you plan your perfect eclipse shot? Stay with me, because today we're turning this rare eclipse into your best photo opportunity of 2025. Let's get started. So why does the moon turn into that airy red during a total lunar eclipse? When the Earth moves between the sun and the moon, it blocks direct sunlight. But here's the cool part. Earth's atmosphere acts like a giant lens, bending light around the planet and sending it to the moon. Now, our atmosphere scatters blue and green light, just like it makes our sky look blue during the day, while red and orange wavelengths pass through more easily. That's why, instead of going dark, the moon gets bathed into a beautiful reddish glow, often called the blood moon. And here's the kicker. The exact shade will depend on what is floating in our atmosphere. Dust, smoke, volcanic particles, they all change the moon's color that night. The lunar eclipse occurs on September 7th. But when and where can you see the total lunar eclipse? Well, let's find out together using PhotoPills. Go to PhotoPills and tap on Planner. And let me show you exactly how to check the visibility and times in a few tabs here in the planner. Okay, now the first thing you need to do is to select the total lunar eclipse you wish to plan. Tap on the map settings button here, and under map layers, go to the eclipse layer, tap on the eclipse layer, and now tap on the eclipse you wish to plan. In this case is the next September 7th, 2025 total lunar eclipse. So tap on this eclipse here and go back to the map. So where the eclipse is visible, you need to zoom out to see the visibility of this eclipse. Also notice that when you select the eclipse, the time bar is set to the date and time of that eclipse on September 7th, 2025 here, pretty cool. Well, the eclipse will be visible here in Asia. It's gonna be visible at moonrise in Africa, Europe, and unfortunately it is not visible in the Americas. Unfortunately, I'm sorry guys. And it's visible at moonset in the Oceania, in New Zealand, Australia. So now you know where the eclipse is visible. What time the eclipse will be visible? You need to go to the eclipse panel here, swipe the top panel to the left until you get to the last eclipse panel, which tells you the time each phase of the eclipse occurs. For example, in Menorca, where I have the red pin here, the moon will rise completely eclipsed. Yeah. So the moon will be rising in totality. Check on the top panel the picture of the moon, how the shadow of Earth falls on the moon. The umbra shadow, it's the totality phase, and the eclipse is maximum at 8:12 p.m. The totality phase ends at 5:53 p.m. and the partial phase ends at 9:59 p.m. and the penumbral eclipse ends at 10:56 p.m. So very quickly, with PhotoPills, we figure out where the eclipse is visible and the times the eclipse will be visible depending on the phase you wish to photograph. And on the top panel, you have a picture where you can see how the eclipse evolves throughout the day. Pretty cool. Oh, and also on the map, you have the moon position, which is marked by this thin blue line that's moving when it changes the time. So you know not only where the eclipse occurs in the world, the time the phases occur, but also where the moon is going to be at all time. And you can also check the view here to visualize the position of the moon when eclipse in the augmented reality view. Pretty cool. All right, now that we know when and where to see it, the biggest question is, how do you actually plan your perfect eclipse shot? Let me walk you through a real example step by step. Okay, let's plan a cool shot of the eclipse rising in Menorca, which is pretty cool. The first thing I'll do is to switch off the moon, the sun layer, because I don't need the sun to plan this lunar eclipse. So tap on layers and tap on the eye next to the sun layer to switch it off, so I only have the moon information on the map. Pretty cool. So now I know that when the moon rises, we'll rise completely eclipse, so in the phase of totality. So based on the moon rise direction, obviously I need to go and plan a cool eclipse shot with the lighthouse. So based on the moon rise direction, which is this thick blue line, choose an interesting subject that can be aligned with the moon and the eclipse. Now zoom on your subject, go go to panel number 2 and tap on the button on the panel to switch the black pin on the map and place it right where you want the moon to be during the eclipse, where you want the eclipse to be, for example, aligned with the Favàritx lighthouse. Pretty cool. And now try to find an initial shooting spot. Let's try this spot here. Pretty cool. And change the time. I'll do a long press on the time bar to change the time more accurately. And I will align the moon line with the black pin. Why? Because now the top panel is telling me the shooting distance, 928.8 meters. This is the distance between the two pins. And also it's telling me the moon height. This is the height of the center of the moon above the terrain where the black pin is. So 18.3 meters. And I know that the lighthouse, Favàritx lighthouse, has a height of 28 meters. So you want to have the eclipse at the top of the lighthouse, you need to just change the time until it says 28 meters, more or less. Pretty cool. I got it here, 27.9 meters. And now the moon is next to the lighthouse, not aligned. So I'll need to change my shooting spot a little bit. For example, here. Okay. To better align it. Okay, good. Maybe too much this time. Go here. Perfect. Okay. That's great. It's aligned. And also on the map, you see how big the moon is going to be during the eclipse. So as you see, the moon is as large as the lighthouse. Also, you have the size of the moon in brackets, 8.7 meters. Pretty cool. But let's check the phase of the eclipse I'll be shooting at this time. Let's go to the eclipse panel, because at this time, yes, I'm photographing the eclipse during totality. Look at the picture on the top panel. The shadow, the red shadow of the Earth falls on the moon. Pretty cool. So it rises completely eclipsed, in this case, in this direction, the direction of the thick line. And then we'll appear behind the rocks, totally eclipsed. There are no clouds in the horizon. And we'll go right at the top of the lighthouse. And it will start moving higher and higher as the eclipse, the phase of the totality of the eclipse, ends later at 8:53 p.m. And as I said at the beginning, the totality time for this eclipse is 1 hour and 22 minutes. You have the time, the duration of the eclipse in the panel number 1 of the eclipse above the map, 1 hour and 22 minutes to shoot totality. Well, in Menorca, a little bit less, because the moon rises completely eclipsed, which I think is even better. Actually, the September full moon is so cool, because it can be also an eclipse depending where you are on Earth, that we decided to run a PhotoPills meetup, PhotoPills wall meetup, to photograph the full moon and the eclipse around the world. So if you want to participate in the PhotoPills wall meetup, you can always submit your plan, send your plan to rafael@photopills.com, and I'll check the plan and I'll upload it on a website so everybody can join your meetup. So yeah guys, time to plan, because the next meetup is gonna be amazing. But going back to my plan here, if on September 7th, 2025, at 8:15 p.m., I am at the red pin position. I'll be able to photograph the total eclipsed moon, a red blood moon aligned with the top of the Favàritx lighthouse. And I think this is going to be our meetup spot for Menorca, which is pretty cool. And the moon size is going to be 8.7 meters, pretty big. Pretty large, pretty nice shot. I can wait. All right, now if you wish to learn how to plan and photograph total lunar eclipses, I invite you to download and study well our super detailed lunar eclipse photography guide. I'm gonna leave a link to the guide in the description of this video and in the first comment below. Download it. And as always, if you like this video, give me a like, subscribe, and I'll see you next Wednesday in another video. And remember, they have the power to imagine, plan, and shoot legendary photos. Bye.